Top of the SportsMax Zone for this Monday. The Jamaica Football Federation is under tremendous pressure ahead of the team's crucial CONCACAF Nations League game against Suriname at the National Stadium in Kingston on Tuesday. Members of the Reggae Boyz team, backed by head coach Paul Hall, have demanded the resignation of the association's General Secretary Dalton Wint. The team returned to Kingston on Monday following a 1-1 draw in Suriname on Saturday. Players are unhappy with the performance of the Gen Sec and say if he is not removed, they will not be taking the field on Tuesday. Our producer Ricardo Chambers caught up with the JFF president Michael Ricketts and defender Damien Lowe on the team's arrival in Kingston early Tuesday morning.
There is a voice note circulating with the players asking for the General Secretary's resignation. Your response to that was, I agree. What exactly does that mean?
That we will look at it this morning. The situation was untenable, to say the least. But like I've said, we will meet this morning and deal with it with some level of urgency, because you understand that this is the nation's business. So we just have to be very serious about what we do. And certainly by 11 o'clock we will meet and we'll do a press release right after.
Is it true that the players have said they will not play tomorrow unless the General Secretary is removed?
Well, a number of things are being said that have not been said to me personally, but I'm not denying that it has not been said. But like I've said, we must deal with it with the highest level of alacrity. And certainly I'm going to call a meeting by 11 o'clock, so certain before the day is through, we'll make an announcement.
Can you say what some of the issues are that the players are having with the Gen Sec?
Well, there seem to be a number of issues. We have met, meaning the players and myself, and they are adamant that this needs to be addressed. They have not individually made these concerns known, but generally there seem to be some issues. And I will meet with the players again later today. We've had some meetings while we were in Suriname, and they are disgruntled, and obviously and apparently some of the staff members are having issues as well.
Yeah. Seems to be some logistical issues, especially as it relates to, seems as if there was a delay in the team coming back to Jamaica. What exactly happened with that?
What actually happened is that from the get-go, we had dialogue with the Surinamese Federation, and the arrangement was that their flight coming to Jamaica, we would share that flight. What happened is that they got some supporters interested, and of course the supporters got priority, so we were denied that opportunity. Immediately we got a flight from Suriname to Port of Spain, and then from Port of Spain into Jamaica. The connection was very tight, so I even reached out to Minister Grange and asked her if she could ask Caribbean Airlines to just delay their flight a little bit so we could ensure that we have enough time to connect. Eventually that flight was cancelled, so we had to now seek to get a chartered flight. That we were able to have done. After we did that, we realized that they could leave no later than midnight. It would mean that we would be, from leaving to get into Jamaica, it would be about 12 hours. The players insisted that that was a little too much for them. So that flight was also canceled. And then, of course, we had to go again to get a flight coming straight into Jamaica.
What about the position of the head coach? We had also heard that he attended his resignation. What is the situation with him?
The situation of the head coach is that he was just giving some solidarity to the players' requests. So that will be addressed today as well.
A lot of things, have been going on in the camp. We've been hearing a lot about the team being disgruntled with the Gen Sec and so on. Can you shed any light on what's happening in that department?
That's an in-house matter. The players are focused on the game right now. That's not something we want to speak about.
Have you at least presented your concerns to the Jamaica Football Federation, and are you confident they will deal with the concerns that you have put forward, if indeed you have?
The Federation is aware of everything that's going on. It's nothing new. I'm sure you guys are aware of some stuff also. But again, like, the players just want to, you know, get the 3 points tomorrow to get back to winning ways and get back on track in qualifying for the next round of the Nations League and the Gold Cup.
Yeah, that's Damien Lowe there. He wore the captain's armband in that 1-1 draw against Suriname. And before that, Michael Ricketts, president of the Jamaica Football Federation. Nothing new to see the JFF caught up in strife with the players and the players unhappy. And Mariah, this is a very, very, very distasteful state of affairs less than 24 hours before an important match.
Can I say how distasteful it is to hear it coming from the players that this is nothing new? Like, we have become so accustomed to these things where a football federation is concerned that, you know, all right, you know, we're going to just try to dust it off and focus on the game. I feel like no player should have to go through those kind of things. And I mean, things involving flights and whatnot, Lance. And as I say, we are just speaking on a couple of information, a bit of information that would have come to hand. Because what we get is that, you know, the players are keeping their lips sealed, you know, not saying too much in that interview that Ricardo had with Damien Lowe. He kept saying the same thing as if it was rehearsed, that, you know, they're focused on the game tomorrow. They really just want to get the 3 points and whatnot. But what I will say is, what in the first match against Suriname, you can tell that a lot of the off-the-field issues had seeped onto the field based on the performance. Andre Blake, somebody I have a lot of high regard for as a goalkeeper and just as a person, you know, from being around the team and whatnot, to see him not suit up for the Reggae Boyz, not play, I felt as if, you know, that had a part to play on the team's performance. It is now 4:45 p.m. in Jamaica, and we still haven't gotten a press release as well from Michael Ricketts and company. They said at 11 a.m. they were going to have a meeting. So that also is very concerning. Is it that we're not going to hear anything and tomorrow the ball kicks off and, you know, everything is swept under the carpet?
Yeah, well, you know what? There is a document being circulated which is purported to be coming from the players. We haven't been able to confirm that. But it ends by saying that the players are drained and tired and enough is enough. I have no reason to think that it is not an authentic document, but it also begs the question about how strident the players appeared to be in one sense, and then confronted by Ricardo Chambers this morning, Damien Lowe didn't really want to say too much, which kind of is understandable because it is something that has to be sorted out. We are on the eve of a match and the players are unhappy, that's very clear. And by his own admission, Michael Ricketts did concede that the situation they encountered over the weekend was untenable. Any professional organization would be embarrassed in a situation like this. And you know, one of the worrying things for me, Mariah, this squad has some young players as they try to rebuild. You know, the Akwasa Chungs and the Earl Simpsons and young players just getting into a Reggae Boyz setup. And for them to be confronted with this level of inefficiency
and unprofessionalism,
it's a sour taste in their mouth to obviously be in a position where they have dreamt about representing the national team on this kind of level, and this is what they are confronted with so early in the experience.
Yeah, it's very, very disheartening, and I like how you put it. You know, a lot of these players, Lance, this is all they've ever wanted to do as a young boy. You know, when you play club football, you play backyard football, whatever, you picture yourself, you know, you foresee yourself in those national colors. And to be honest, when you are faced with these kind of situations, you have no zeal to focus on your football because you are so caught up in, will I get the flight to go? And I don't care who says that, you know, as professionals, you're going to just dust everything off, because when you work in an environment that is not conducive to productivity, there's no way that that is not going to affect you.
Yeah, and of course, this latest incident is almost a culmination of a proliferation of indiscretions that we've seen from the JFF. More pointedly, the GenSec, who has been at the heart of a lot of criticism for errors and bunglings that we've seen in the past few years. So the players feel they have had enough. In fact, the JFF is under so much pressure because they are getting fire from all angles. CONCACAF would have fined them over the weekend because they arrived at the match late.
And I want to believe, and I'm not right, we have no evidence, but it had to be a build-up to what took place. It had to be a build-up, and I will also add to that to say that the players would not have reacted in this manner, Lance, if it was just one happening. You'd have been like, all right, it's a one-off. You know, it's unfortunate that we didn't get a flight. But you could tell that it's a build-up of so many different things, not one, not two, not three.
Yeah, and there was a press conference with Coach Paul Hall earlier on today. It was 1 o'clock local time. I listened to it, and it was pretty hard to digest Paul Hall's utterances during that press conference, because he tried to paint a positive picture, because I think at the end of the day, he feels that the team is preparing for an important match, and whatever is being discussed behind closed doors, he didn't want to discuss that in the press conference, which I guess is understandable, but there were burning issues there that needed to be dealt with, and he just kept skipping over them, which I said is understandable because obviously there are meetings going on. And the president of the JFF did say that there was to be a meeting at 11 this morning, after which there would have been a press release issued. Now, we haven't seen a press release yet, so I gather that meetings are still going on, even though I think the team would be going to training now, so I'm not sure where that stands. This issue isn't over. After the break, we'll continue to talk about the strife that the Reggae Boyz are in 24 hours before Suriname in their Nations League match at the stadium in Kingston.
Welcome back to the SportsMax Zone, and we continue with the issue from the first segment. There were reports that Reggae Boyz head coach Paul Hall had tendered his resignation. As you heard in our interview with JFF President Michael Ricketts, that was a move of solidarity with the players. And earlier today at a press conference, Hall confirmed he will guide the team for Tuesday's match against Suriname.
I can't speak about non-footballing matters. All I know is that I'll be there on the sideline, on the pitch tomorrow, giving my all, because that's what we do. It's really, really important that everybody is behind this team tomorrow. We know how important it is for Jamaican football. We know how important it is that we have fans in the stadium, and everybody needs to get behind this team. Yes, I will definitely be there tomorrow, 150%.
It goes against the general rhetoric of the players, but Hall also expressed confidence that the focus of the players will not be impacted by the off-field issues.
Players are focused. They're very focused. We all know what we want from this. We want to be the number one team in CONCACAF, but that's what we want. All the boys, all the players, we want that. We've got high standards. Even the boys that's come in, they've come in with so much conversation about beating Suriname and beating Mexico and really going forward in the future and really becoming a team to be reckoned with consistently in the future. And when you hear that, then you can only be given confidence and push forward and make sure that we create an environment for the players and the staff to flourish.
Lance, how do we reconcile Hall's comments against the general rhetoric from the players?
Well, what I hear from Paul Hall is someone who is trying his best not to, as we would say, you know, wash the JFF's dirty linen in public.
Oh, it's already been washed, though.
I know, but I'm just saying in a press conference format, he doesn't want to add to that. So he did, because this press conference lasted, I think, about 40 or 45 minutes. It was pretty long. And every time he was pressed to deal with the issues or to respond directly to the issues that surfaced over the weekend, he skipped away from that and focused on the game and how, you know, the players have to focus on the game and so on. But the fact is that the players are unhappy, and I have no reason to not believe their threat that they aren't willing to play if the GenSec isn't fired.
Okay.
You know, so I just think he was in a position where if it is that they settle the issues and the match is going to be played, because that has to be the end game. The end game has to be playing this match on Tuesday evening. And he just, to me, tried his best to paint that kind of picture and stay away from the issues that are obviously being hammered out behind closed doors, because the player's threat would have to be taken seriously by the JFF.
But Lance, can I say that, you know, based on being a part of the press conference too, I get the feeling that coach was instructed not to talk about those things. Because I want to just juxtapose that to the press release that came out, the one that we're still trying to confirm and whatnot. If you, coach, are in solidarity with the players, because that's why yesterday he was even willing to resign his job, because he wanted to be in solidarity with the players, then today, you know, we hear a different story. And while we're hearing this different story, clearly somebody is drafting up this press release from the players. So I get the sense that there's a bit of disaccord within the camp. You know, there's not... Everybody isn't on the same page, you know. Coach is being told in this press conference, these journalists are going to drill you. Yes. You will stick to the narrative. Meanwhile, the players in the back are saying, well, you know, as much as coach is supporting us, you know, we are not okay with this and we're still not taking the field. So then, you know, I'm yet to read that press release, because it came when I was just about to get ready for the show, Lance. But from the sentiments that you've echoed before and the ones that you said, they still stand by what they say.
Mm. Yeah, and part of the problem that we're struggling with here is the issue of the consistent and the repeated indiscretions from the JFF's performance as administrators of the game and booking flights and so on. We hear horror stories about overseas-based players going to airports all over the world, from Europe to to Asia, to the USA, wherever, for their flights and finding out that there are no flights booked for them. Now, there's no way that a player can experience something like that and not become very angry. And beyond getting angry, wanting to ensure that it doesn't happen again. And if every time these things happen, the Jensek Dalton Wint is the person that the finger is being pointed at, then it stands to reason that the players have had enough with this Jensek and they need more efficiency coming from him.
Yeah, and then people lose respect for you, because, Lance, it comes as if you have one job to do every day, and every time I come to you, you mess it up. Eventually, there will be a sort of problem with us if we're trying to, you know, have a professional environment. Everybody will start hating on you, you know, and they will call for your removal, and I get that's what we're seeing here. And I keep hearing in the press conference, and I want to hear your take on this, that, you know, we're focusing on the game and that, you know, these things will be discussed behind the scenes and whatnot. Do you genuinely believe that things happening in these meetings will not affect the performance on the field? Do you expect tomorrow to see these players come out all guns blazing, you know, confidence right up and turn around from what we saw last night?
Well, there's every indication that their game will be negatively affected by what has transpired over the last 48 hours. At the risk of sounding facetious, the only thing I could say is if before game time they hear that the Jensek is fired...
And they celebrate, and then they go out and they're like, this
might,
one is for
it
you.
It might make them happy and they play well. That's the best that I could say. But this is a very, very unfortunate situation. And I am... sad to admit or to concede here that, you know, this is something that we would have had to see coming, because it keeps happening. The players keep talking about how the administrative performance of the Jamaica Football Federation is way, way, way below standard. And the same people are still involved. And as a result, the same things keep happening.
Yeah, well, Lance, we have a lot more still to come on the show. We discuss the West Indies tour of Netherlands, even as they arrive in Pakistan for a 3-match one-day international series. Plus, the Regional 40 tournament, which ended at the weekend. And Rafael Nadal will be in the spotlight after winning his 22nd major title. But how many more times will we see the Spaniard? It's a serious question because of a chronic problem. But coming up next, our NBA segment, Alistair Albert's prediction of a 4-2 win for the Warriors over the Celtics remains on course after the Golden State Warriors leveled the 7-game series 1-1 on Sunday night. Back with more after this.
Thank you for watching SportsMax on YouTube. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and click the notification bell to stay informed.